2023 was the warmest year on record. Climate change is changing everything. It is causing deaths, injuries, and diseases for workers everywhere. Climate change is leading to excessive heat, extreme weather, UV radiation, air pollution, and an alarming increase in certain diseases. These are just some of the dangers that are threatening the health and safety of workers and putting their jobs at risk. 2.4 billion workers are exposed to excessive heat at work every single year. And the total number has gone up over 35% over the last two decades. Our most recent data shows that over 26.2 million people are living with chronic kidney disease related to workplace heat stress. Excessive heat kills around 19,000 workers and injures around 23 million workers every year. UV radiation is impacting even more workers, around 1.6 billion, and killing 19,000 per year due to skin cancer. In addition, these 1.6 billion outdoor workers may be exposed to air pollution too, resulting in some 860,000 work-related deaths. Outdoor workers are also vulnerable to vector-borne diseases, which kill around 15,000 workers every year. Climate change is leading to an increase in the use of agrochemicals, putting the over 900 million agricultural workers worldwide at risk of exposure. Every year, 300,000 die of pesticide poisoning. Each of these climate-related hazards represents a threat in and within itself, but they are also uniquely interlinked and may result in a cocktail of hazards. The cumulative effect may pose an unprecedented threat to humanity, and we do not have the full picture of the real impact yet. This highlights the multidimensional challenge that lies before us. Climate change is a health issue. It is a workplace issue. It is also a social justice issue. But above all, it is a human rights issue. It needs to top the list of our global priorities. Going forward, workers and workplaces must be at the center of climate change action. Heat action plans must prioritize workers' safety and health. And legislation on occupational safety and health needs to mainstream climate change hazards as a matter of urgency. We are in a sprint to save lives, and the time to act is now.